Hello and welcome back to another Python challenge. So this challenge, we need to write a function that strips and returns a username for any given email address. So you need to build a function that has one parameter, and then it needs to be able to take in an email address like this. And then the output of that function should just be, in this case, or this example, should just be user. So we're trying to just strip out the username, if you like, from the email and return it to the user. So to complete this challenge, we're going to need to utilize, or one of the tools that we can utilize here is split. So let's just go for an example first. So let's say email equals, and let's just create a simple email, user@org.com. Okay, so let's just go ahead and use split and see what happens here. So split, a built-in function. So we need to, first of all, define what we want to split. So email and then split. Okay, so what we can do here is we can define where we want to split. So we can pass in, for example, in this case, dot. So this is defining the fact, or is telling Python to basically find the dot and then to split whatever there is in between from the left and the right. Split that up and put that into a list. So let's go ahead and give that a go, and we can see that in action. So you can see that we've created a list, and you can see that on the left and the right hand side of the dot, the full stop here, the word or the string has been broken up. So what we can do now, if you like, is we can split at the @. So every single email address has an @ symbol, so we can split this up left to right. Give that a go. We can now see that we've split that up. So we're now returning user and org.com. So if you're familiar with utilizing these type of data structures, you know you can now access these different strings utilizing the list index. So behind the scenes then, this is index, this is position 0, this is position 1. So let's go ahead and just extend this slightly and say position 0. So we're now going to get position 0 of this split we've made here in this list, and that should just return user. If you're not too familiar with Python data structures, then by all means go over to the homepage for the channel. There's a course here called Python Beginners. Inside of here, you should find a lesson on data collections here, and that will take you through the general principles of utilizing lists, tuples, and dictionaries. So now we can access a single email address. Let's think about how we could write a function and think about returning multiple email addresses. Maybe we give a list of email addresses, and that returns then all the users of those emails. So I've gone ahead and just created this list here of emails. You can extend this and add more. So we just need to make a few changes here in this. Let's go ahead and create a for loop here. So for, let's say, just X in emails. So what we're doing here is we're making a loop. And what we're going to do, we're going to loop over, iterate over this list here. So there's two items here. So there's two loops. What's going to happen is that this email address is going to be passed into email. Goes over to X, and then what we're going to say is we're going to say X split. So we're just going to split that like we did previously, and then that's going to print off just the username. Now we're going to need to put that in square brackets. Again, we then print this off, and then the iterator will then iterate over this and bring this in. So the second email goes into X and then prints it off. Obviously, if we add more, it will obviously print those off too. So let's go back in and print that off. And that's currently what gets returned, which is interesting. So the reason why that is, what's happened here is this is an example of the fact that the string here is iterable. So every single letter we can iterate over. And I notice here that in actual fact, I want emails and not email. That's the problem there. So let's go back in and just iterate over this list now. And there we go. So we've now returned the users for this list of emails. So this is something you might not have seen before, and I didn't explain what's happened here. Notice that I've used the square brackets, and this is indicating the fact that we're going to return a list. And notice that we've used a for loop here with inside a list. So there is an equivalent here. This is equivalent of the following code. So for example, let's say x equals an empty list. And now we're going to say for x in emails. And we're then going to perform some sort of action. So x dot split. And then we just finish off the split as per normal, sorry, the at symbol. Okay, so, and then we just grab the first item, so the username. And then what we can do here is we can update this list here. So let's just call this, actually let's just call this y, this list y. So we can say, for example, y dot append, and then we basically go ahead and then split x, so that then gets placed inside of this list here. So just to recap here, so these are the emails, so we iterate over the emails here. So this email then goes into this for loop, goes into x, and then what we do is we then append. So append basically adds items to our empty list here. And what we're going to add, well, we're going to split whatever is in x at the moment, which is the first item here. And then we then pass that using append into the list here. So if I were to print this list now, print y, that should print out what we had previously had. So just get rid of that. And there we go. So the results are exactly the same. So this is just a shorthand way, what you see here, of creating a list and running a for loop within. So if you're a little bit more interested in that, this is called list comprehension. So by all means, just type that into Google and there'll be plenty more examples of that. So just to finish this challenge, let's now just remove this and finish off by creating our function. So we can build a really simple function to solve the problem in the challenge. Oh, def, let's say, yeah, return username. And we're gonna take in or set a parameter, take in an email address, and let's just return e.split. And we're gonna split at the at symbol. And then we're just gonna grab the first item. And then we can then just simply pass something in. So let's say we can ask the user to input, maybe. So let's say input, enter email. And then we can go ahead and print return username and then pass in x. So we're going to pass in the user's input into this function. It's going to be grabbed into e. And then we can utilize that to split and then return, and we're going to print off just their username. So hopefully that should work. So let's give that a go. So we're going to run this file and enter an email address, user@org.com. And then that just returns the user.